Vâng. Ngày đi chuyện ngày sau là cá từ lưới cá bị nứt xả xây để xem xem bát đời ban cá này nhạt vì ai đóng bờ thiên ong chuẩn bị thả lá cá cầm pu này ong chuẩn bị vị sầm ánh không thả lá cá cầm bờ chía nhóm bát xiêm máu cả lá bình chi này ong chuẩn bị thả lá cá cầm pu này ovotoko som an này bát bình chi tây không sầm ráp cá cướp cong sao sao là cá không ngày sao là cá đi Bắt bình chiếp tây khăn nông cực cồng xa là sao nà ká khăn nông thay sao nà ká Đàm bây đã xa nơi dần đạp thân hợp rồi xa nơi sốc Nâng đập nà ká là ô khăn nông phê là sao nà ká Và thiên ông chúng ta là ká gầm phù Xâm rách đạn chênh nơi bắt bình chiếp tây khăn nông cực cồng xa là sao nà ká Khăn nông cùng lông phê là sao nà ká lưu bật đăng xa túc khăn nông xùm nông rương xôn xôn phí Vẹn mũi đôi khẳng cọng
One, all persons who wish to attend the hearing shall be present in the courtroom of the extraordinary chambers in the courts of Cambodia
Toute personne assistant aux audiences.
By 8:40 a.m. and before 1:30 p.m. Participants and persons in the public gallery shall stand when the gravity announces stand and sit when the president of the Supreme Court chamber announces sit down, except the venerable ones. Three, participants shall maintain dignified and proper behavior in the courtroom at all times. Participants shall wear appropriate clothing and should not display slogans indicating their support for a party of the proceedings.
Four,
all cameras, camcorders, tape recorders, and loudspeakers are prohibited in the courtroom, except as approved by the President of the Supreme Court Chamber.
Five,
smoking or bringing food or drinks inside the courtroom is prohibited.
Six.
All weapons, explosives, ammunition and inflammable substances are prohibited inside the courtroom except for those carried by the ECCC's authorized security guards. Seven, the use of cell phones is strictly prohibited. Phone cameras and phone audio recordings are also prohibited except as approved by the President of the SCC. 8. All persons are prohibited from changing seats or walking freely inside the courtroom. 9. All persons are prohibited from clapping, cheering, shouting, or making loud noises that might disrupt the hearing. 10.
Tout autre comportement qui pourrait perturber les audiences.
Permission must be granted by an ECCC authorized security guard in order to enter or exit
the courtroom. 11.
Children under 16 years of age are prohibited from entering the courtroom.
L'accès au prétoire
persons between 16 and 18 years of age may enter the courtroom if they are accompanied by a parent or legal guardian,
d'un tuteur ou d'un parent.
Unless they are attending the public hearing as civil parties.
À moins qu'ils participent à l'audience en qualité de partie civile.
If anyone finds to violate the regulations, the Supreme Court, the president of the Supreme Court chamber may take preventative measures. Ordinary action against any person who breaches these internal regulations. Phnom Penh, 17 November 2000.
Règlement décidé à Phnom Penh.
July 2015.
Le président, veuillez vous asseoir.
Please be seated.
President,
in the name of the United Nations and the Cambodian people, the SEC opens an appeal hearing of the parties against the judgment dated 7 August 2014 by the trial chamber of the ACCC in case 02, dated 19 September 2007, where Nguyen Chi and Khieu Samphan are the co-accused.
Dossier pénal dans lequel Nguyen Chi et Khieu Samphan sont co-accusés.
Today, the composition of the Sao Po chambers are as follows.
La composition de la Chambre de la Cour suprême, juge Consrim, président,
judge Anjitska Milad,
juge
Agnieszka
Milad,
juge
Som
Florence Mumba,
juge Florence Mumba,
judge Mongmani Charya,
judge
Chandra Nihal Yashinge,
juge Chandra Yashinge et juge Yanarin.
The greffiers, Mr.
Les greffiers
Walker Nerich, Mr. Siamau, Mr. Sela Pailan,
Mr.
Pablo Loba, and
Mr. Pan Thun.
Greffier, all the parties present.
Je demande à présent aux greffiers de prononcer sur le statut des parties à l'audience.
Mr. President,
for today's proceedings, all parties to this case are present.
Toutes les parties à l'audience sont présentes.
And both accused, Nguyen Chi and Khieu Samphan, are present as well.
Et Khieu Samphan sont dans le prétoire.
We have participation of 10 civil parties, namely Madame Chim Sovan, Madame Mom Sam-eun, Mr. Misaran,
Madame
Auri, Madame Tang Sokha, Mr. Own Polly,
Madame Sang
Arat,
Madame
Chan
Sochiat,
Mr. Chen Rumdul,
and
Madame Po Dina.
Thank you, Mr. President. Merci, Monsieur le Président.
President,
on 7 August 2014, the trial chamber issued a judgment in case
002/01,
finding accused Khieu Samphan and Nguyen Chi guilty of the crimes against humanity of extermination,
de crimes contre l'humanité,
encompassing murder, persecution on political grounds,
and
other inhuman
acts, actes inhumains,
comprising forced transfer, forced disappearances, and attacks against human dignity committed within the territory of Cambodia between 17 April 1975 and the end of 1977.
Et la fin de l'année 1977.
Therefore, the trial chamber convicted the two accused
la
and sentenced them to life
imprisonment. Les condamnés à purger une peine de réclusion.
On 29 September 2014,
le 29 septembre
2014, Nunchi and Kyo Sopon filed their notices of appeal against the trial chamber's judgment.
Contre le jugement de la
with Nunchi raising 223rd. Ground 23 grounds of appeal and Kyo Sopon raising 148 grounds of appeal and filing subsequent motions on 29 September 2014. The co-prosecutors also filed their notice of appeal.
Ont aussi déposé leur avis d'appel.
Upon receipt of the two accused motions, the Supreme Court chamber granted the motions in part, permitting Nunchi and Kyo Sopon to extend the page limit and time to file the appeal brief due to the scope and complexity of the case. The Supreme Court chamber also permitted the co-prosecutors to extend the page limit and time to file the English language version of their consolidated response, which was filed on 24 April 2015 with the Khmer translation to follows.
La traduction en Khmer
on 29 December 2014, Nunchi and Kyo Sopon filed the appeal briefs in English and French. The appeal briefs request the Supreme Court chamber, inter alia, to summon 9 witnesses, including those who have been identified in the accused first request and third request. On 29 May 2015,
le 29 mai 2015,
the Supreme Court chamber issued a decision to admit as evidence the written record of witness interview in accordance with Rule 108.7 of the Internal Rules and summons witnesses, namely SCW3, SCW4, SCW5, to testify before the Supreme Court chamber, proprio motu, in accordance with Rule
104.1
of the Internal Rules. And the chamber remains seized of Nunchi's request to summon other witnesses,
Heng
Samrin, Robert Lemkin,
Okun Chun, Ted Sambat,
and witnesses SCW1 and SCW2. The chamber affirms that the hearing on the party's appeal in case 002/01 has commenced.
La chambre affirme que l'audience
this hearing is specifically intended to examine the three witnesses requested in Nunchi's appeal,
mais l'audience est prévue pour entendre trois témoins
additional evidence.
Dans l'appel et la troisième requête,
the chamber has found that first, in the interest of justice, it is necessary to hear witnesses SCW3 and SCW4 in accordance with Rule 104.1 of the Internal Rules, and second, the testimony of witness SCW5, who was not available at trial, could be a decisive factor in reaching a decision in accordance with Rule 108.7 of the Internal Rules. Given that this hearing is intended to hear only these three witnesses,
l'audience d'aujourd'hui a pour but,
the parties are not expected to make oral arguments relating to the matters set out in the appeals
sur des questions
and hearings on the substance of the appeals will later be scheduled in due course.
Seront prévus en temps utile.
The chamber recalls that the present procedures follow the jurisprudence of
que les procédures actuelles suivent la jurisprudence
the ICTR
du TPIR.
Yesterday, the Supreme Court chamber decides on the optics and of the use of documents as reference in putting questions to the witnesses, the questionings or follow the guidelines set out by the SEC, and today the SEC will hear testimony of SCW4, that is SAO 1, and tomorrow we will hear the witness SCW3, and on Monday next week we will hear testimony of SCW5. I would like now to hand the floor to Judge Yanaren and Judge Mamba to present the report.
Pour faire présentation de leur rapport.
Judge Yanaren.
Le juge Yanaren.
Co-rapporteur's report for hearings of the 2nd, 3rd, and 6th July 2015. As stated by the President, the principal purpose of our hearings is to hear the testimonies of witnesses at CW4, 3, and 5, respectively. Nunchi submits that their testimony could have a bearing on the correctness of the trial chamber's finding, relating in particular to the command structure within the Communist Party of Kampuchea, that is CPK, the CPK policy to target command public soldiers and officials, and finally the executions at Turbochere. Accordingly, the scope of my report will be confined through those grounds of appeal that are directly related to those issues. This is not to suggest, however, that their testimonies could not eventually be considered relevant to other grounds of appeal as well. I shall first set out the party's submissions regarding the command structure. I shall then hand over to my co-rapporteur, Judge Mamba, who shall summarize the party's submissions regarding the other issues. First, on the CPK command structure. The trial chamber found that control over the CPK was ultimately exercised by the Standing Committee, an extra-statutory body composed of seven members, including Nunchi. Kyu Sampon was never a member of the Standing Committee, but he attended some meetings.
Mais il a participé à certaines de ces réunions.
The trial chamber affirmed that the party center relied inter alia on the zones, that is, the administrative areas in which Democratic Cambodia was divided, to implement its decisions. The trial chamber also found that the party center designed and coordinated population movements as well as policies regarding enemies. The trial chamber held that decisions were made according to the so-called principle of democratic centralism. This meant, on the other hand, that decisions within the party were made collectively as opposed to individually, and on the other hand, that decisions were taken centrally by the upper echelons of the party. Finally, the trial chamber made findings regarding the lines of communication within the CPK. In this regard, it determined that the zones and autonomous sectors reported directly to and received directions from the party center. For example, messages from the zones contained requests for instructions or material assistance from the party center, while officials at the zone level received letters from the party center or individual CPK leaders, including Nunchi and Kyu Sampon. In his appeal, Nunchi submits that the trial chamber failed to substantiate its findings concerning the CPK cadres acting within a unified, rigidly heretical and pyramidal entity.
Fondé ses constatations concernant les faits que les
cadres du parti. He further asserts that the trial chamber unreasonably downplayed the authority of the zone leaders,
a minimisé de façon déraisonnable l'autorité des chefs de zone qui avaient des pouvoirs décisionnels indépendants out et donc ont that pu did not agir fall within the à l'extérieur des politiques du PCK ou instructions.
Nguyen-Chi argues that the trial chamber mischaracterized evidence demonstrating that communications issues by the party center, including Nguyen-Chi, were rare and did not contemplate the commission of criminal acts.
Envoyées par le centre du parti, y compris Nguyen-Chi, étaient rares.
Nguyen-Chi averts that the trial chamber ignored that the zone armies were in conflict, which he argues is contrary to its characterization of the CPK as a unified party.
Des armées de zone qui étaient en conflit. Et argue que
additionally, he submits that the trial chamber erred in refusing to hear witnesses who interacted with powerful officials in the administrative structure.
In
his appeal, he was upon submitting that the trial chamber committed an error by misconstruing all of the evidence from which it can be inferred that he was not present at the meeting at which the decision to evacuate Phnom Penh might have taken place.
Qui montre qu'il
he further argues that the trial chamber committed an error
in stating
that
Kyaw
Sompon had decision-making powers within the Central Committee,
even though he allegedly was merely a candidate member. Kyaw
Sompon contends that the trial chamber did not state which people were concerned each time it used the terms party center and Onka, which led to wrongly conclude that Kyaw Sompon
utilise des termes comme centre du parti ou
was involved in the policies of
DK. Avait participé aux politiques du Kampuchea.
Finally, Kyaw Sompon submits that the trial chamber committed an error in its analysis of the command structure of the armed forces and their relationship with the party center.
De commandement des forces armées de leur relation
the co-prosecutors state in their response that the trial chamber reasonably assessed the role of the zone leaders within the hierarchical structure of the CPK. They further averred that the trial chamber correctly characterized the evidence of instructions issued by the party center, which were neither rare nor limited in scope and substance. Finally, they argue that Kyaw Sompon fails to show any error in the trial chamber's findings regarding the powers of the Central Committee,
lines
of communications,
the
military structure, the principles of democratic centralism and secrecy, and the import of terms such as party center and
Onkar.
I shall now hand over to my co-rapporteur, Judge Mumba, who will set out the party's submissions regarding the targeting of Khmer Republic soldiers and officials
and the executions at Toul Poutre.
The second part, targeting Khmer Republic soldiers and officials. The trial chamber held that the CPK was committed to a policy endorsed by its party leaders to target former Khmer Republic soldiers and officials for arrests, disappearances, and executions. This policy existed before, on, and after 17th April 1975. The trial chamber also established that Khmer Rouge soldiers intended to kill Khmer Republic officials on a massive scale and as a result committed extermination and political persecution. The trial chamber found a clear pattern of mass executions, including the murders at Toul Poutre. In his appeal, Nguyen-Chi submits that the trial chamber made factual errors in assessing evidence regarding the policy allegedly adopted by the CPK to target Khmer Republic soldiers and officials.
Nunchia
argues that no such policy or pattern existed either before, during or after April 1975. In support of his argument, he posits that the trial chamber failed to correctly assess the evidence. Notably, the trial chamber, inter alia, made selective use of evidence, cited to unreliable sources, referenced insufficient evidence concerning killings and mischaracterized exculpatory evidence. Nunchia therefore concludes that the trial chamber failed to consider alternative readings from the relevant evidence and accordingly committed an error in finding crimes at two portrayed based on a joint criminal enterprise.
Insuffisante à des preuves sur
in his appeal,
Kyu Sampham
submits that the trial chamber erred in finding that there was a policy of targeting Khmer Republic soldiers because it ignored the oppressive nature of the Lon Nol regime and the raging war in the background. He contends that for its finding that Khmer Republic soldiers were executed at Udong, the trial chamber should not have relied on Kyu Sampham's statement in a speech given in 1974 that 5,000 enemies had been eliminated, as this was an exaggerated propagandist and unreliable source. In this regard, Kyu Sampham avers that the trial chamber erred by relying on poorly supporting evidence of mass executions, citing to magazines without considering their context and drawing contradictory conclusions. Kyu Sampham finally asserts that the trial chamber manipulated the chronology of evidence by citing to sources dated after the end of armed conflict. The co-prosecutors respond that the trial chamber was reasonable in finding that there was a policy to target Khmer Republic soldiers and officials for arrests, disappearances, and executions. They also maintained that this pattern was nationwide and large-scale. As for Nunchia's appeal, the co-prosecutors argue that the trial chamber bets its holding on the careful consideration of evidence as a whole and as part of a consistent pattern to target the soldiers. They also argue against the need to discuss every alternative interpretation that the evidence might suggest. As to Kyu Sampham, the co-prosecutors state that he makes general and meritless assertions that fail to demonstrate the trial chamber's errors. Third, to portray, the trial chamber found that around 25th or 26th April 1975, at least 250 former Khmer Republic soldiers and officials were transported to Portray and then killed as part of a CPK policy to target former members of the Lon Nol regime for execution. The trial chamber established that executions occurred at two Portray, principally based on evidence given by three witnesses, whom it believed to be credible. The trial chamber held that although none of the witnesses were present at the two Portray sites, it had heard a significant amount of evidence from which it could safely draw inferences. In his appeal, Nunchia submits that the trial chamber erred by failing to seriously scrutinize evidence from the only three witnesses that testified about two Portray. In particular, even though these witnesses were far removed from the events at issue and gave contradictory evidence, the trial chamber portrayed the evidence as coherent and reliable. Nunchia maintains that the trial chamber committed errors in finding that the alleged CPK's policy to target former Khmer Republic officials involved the extermination of former Khmer Republic officials at two portrayed. Nunchia finally contends that the trial chamber's factual findings on superior responsibility merely replicated its findings on Nunchia's liability for commission through joint criminal enterprise, which Nunchia has already submitted to be incorrect. In his appeal, Kyu Sampham posits that the trial chamber aided in holding that he had knowledge of the crimes at two portrayed because it has not been established beyond reasonable doubt that he was aware of a pattern of target Khmer Republic soldiers and officials. He also argues that the trial chamber committed errors by basing some of its findings on facts outside the ECCC's temporal jurisdiction. He further contends that the trial chamber erred in law by varying the scope of the proceedings up to the end of the trial, thereby preventing an effective defense
Il argue aussi que la Chambre de première instance a commis des erreurs en fond dans certaines de ses constatations sur des faits à l'extérieur de
from
la
the standpoint of measures
compétence
temporelle specific groups,
des CETC.
Not enemies.
Il affirme aussi que la Chambre de première instance a fait une erreur de droit en...
Slow down. Okay. Q. Sampam submits that the trial chamber committed an error in stating that a mere demonstration of the intention to participate in a common purpose is enough to establish the mens rea for executions at two poach rates. Finally, Q. Sampam maintains that the trial chamber aided in finding that he knew crimes would be committed at two poach rates, that his presence at some meetings of the Khmer Rouge leadership had made a determining contribution to those crimes, and that his criminal responsibility could be inferred from his alleged participation in a joint criminal enterprise. The co-prosecutors respond to the trial chamber's conclusions concerning the events at Two Poach Ray were reasonable and based on the totality of the evidence. They posit that the trial chamber reasonably relied on the testimonies of the three witnesses mentioned, which was corroborated by other evidence. The co-prosecutors further maintain that the trial chamber reasonably found that there was a policy to target former Khmer Republic soldiers and officials at Two Poach Ray. Finally, they assert that Q. Sampam does not make reference to the knowledge or intent requirements and fails to demonstrate how any such error in that regard would invalidate the decision.
Et finalement, ils affirment que Q. Sampam ne fait aucune référence à la connaissance ou aux intentions requises et n'a pas démontré que les erreurs étaient suffisantes pour invalider la décision.
Court officer, place us a witness SCW4 into the courtroom.
Monsieur le greffier, veuillez faire entrer le témoin SCW4.
President, I'd like to make my observation regarding the proceedings. In fact, the Khmer rendition is rather fast and it's very difficult to make sense through the interpretation system. So please, Mr. President, could you instruct all parties and speakers to speak slower?
Thank you.
President, parties, please be advised that please slow down during your presentation.
J'enjoins les parties de ralentir.
Thank you. President, Mr. Witness, you have been summoned by the Supreme Court Chamber of the ECCC to testify before it. And questions will be put to you first by the co-accused defense teams, and then followed by other parties. And first of all, may we know your name?
Par les autres parties.
The interpreter cannot hear the witness.
Les interprètes n'entendent pas le témoin.
Hello.
President, Mr. Witness,
le président, pour
please observe the microphone and you should only speak when you see the red light on the tip of the microphone, otherwise your voice does not go through the interpretation system. And let me start again. What is your name, Mr. Witness?
Quel est votre nom?
Witness, my name is Sao Won.
Je m'appelle Question. Sao Won.
Do you have any alias?
Question. Avez-vous un surnom?
Answer. I am also known by Sao Po.
Réponse. Oui, je suis aussi connu sous
President,
le nom de Sao
when
Po.
Were you born? Answer.
Question.
I was born on the 15th April 1941.
Réponse. Le 15 avril 1941.
Please turn on the Mr. President's microphone.
Le micro du président est éteint.
President, what is your nationality?
Quelle est votre nationalité, s'il vous plaît?
Answer, I am
Réponse,
Khmer.
Réponse, je suis Khmer.
Question, what is your current occupation?
Question, quelle est votre profession actuelle?
Answer.
Réponse.
I am a rice farmer at present.
Je suis riziculteur.
And I am also a member of the commune council.
Je suis également membre du conseil
Question,
de la commune de
what
Tiengtong.
Is your father's name?
Question, comment s'appelle votre père?
Answer, my
Réponse,
father's name is Sao Mi.
Mon
He
père s'appelle Sao
away.
Mi. Il est décédé.
Question,
Question,
and what is your mother's name?
Et comment s'appelle votre mère?
Answer, her name is Sok Ke.
Réponse, elle s'appelle
She
Sok Ke.
Also passed away.
Elle aussi est décédée.
Question, and what
Question.
Is your wife's name?
Comment s'appelle votre femme?
And answer, Nyam
Réponse,
Un is my
Nyam
wife's
Un.
Name. Question, is she alive?
Question, est-elle en vie?
Answer, yes, she is.
Réponse, oui.
Question, how many children,
Question.
How many sons and daughters?
Combien d'enfants avez-vous? Combien de fils et de filles avez-vous?
Answer, I have 9 children,
Réponse, j'ai 9 enfants,
sons,
5 fils
daughters.
Et 4 filles.
Question,
Question,
where is your current address?
Où vivez-vous actuellement?
Answer,
Réponse,
I live in Srai Khwai village,
Je vis dans le village de Srai Khwai,
commune
de Tiengtong, district de Tramkok, province de Takeo.
Question, Mr. Witness, are you related
Question.
To any
témoin,
of the two accused or any of the civil parties?
De l'un des accusés ou de l'une des parties civiles?
Answer, no.
Réponse,
I
non.
I am not related to
Je
any
n'ai aucun
of
lien
the accused
avec
or the
quelconque des accusés.
Question, have you taken an oath before
Question,
your
avez-vous
appearance?
Prêté serment avant de venir comparaître?
Answer, yes, I have.
Réponse, oui.
President, Mr. Witness.
Le président.
Do you
Monsieur le témoin.
Have a right against self-incrimination.
Vous avez le droit
This means
de
you may refuse to respond to any questions or comment that they may incriminate
vous
you.
Refuser de répondre à des commentaires ou des questions.
However, you
de
must respond to all
Néanmoins,
questions put to you, and you must tell the truth based
posées.
On your what you heard,
vous devez
witness,
parler de ce
remembered,
que vous avez vu, entendu,
or experienced,
vous
or observed
vécu,
directly in any
to
the event
par rapport,
as part of the questions put to you.
Aux questions qui vous sont posées.
And Mr. Witness,
Monsieur le témoin,
have you been interviewed or appeared before the ECCC?
Avez-vous déjà déposé devant les CETC ou avez-vous déjà été
Answer.
Entendu?
Yes, I
Réponse.
Previously appeared before the ECCC.
Oui, j'ai déjà comparu devant les CETC.
question. Was it during a trial or was it before the co-investigating charges?
Était-ce pendant un procès ou bien était-ce au cours d'entretien avec les enquêteurs des co-juges d'instruction?
Answer, I appeared before the co-investigating charges.
J'ai répondu aux questions chamber, des co-juges d'instruction.
Question. The chamber would like to hand the floor first to the co-counsels for Nunchi to put questions to the witness,
and you may proceed, counsel. Ce sont eux qui vont interroger le témoin. Vous avez la parole, maître.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Maître Copé,
good morning,
Monsieur le Président.
Your Honours.
Bonjour, good morning, Madame, counsel. Mesdames et Messieurs les juges.
Good morning, Mr. Witness. My name is Victor Copé. I am the international co-counsel for Nunchi. And I would like to ask you some questions this morning. You just answered a question from the President about your statement to investigators of the co-investigating judge. Did you give that statement in February 2013?
Answer. I gave an interview in 2013.
J'ai donné un entretien en 2013. C'est à ce moment-là que j'ai apporté des réponses.
And when you gave that interview, was that done at the commune hall of Changtong?
Cela s'est-il fait à Changtong, dans dans le bureau de la commune de Changtong?
Answer.
Réponse.
Yes.
Oui.
I was interviewed at the Changtong Commune
J'ai
Office.
J'ai été entendu dans le bureau de la commune de Changtong.
Mr. Witness, did you also
Question.
Speak
Monsieur
to investigators
Avez-vous également
of
parlé
an organization
aux enquêteurs
called DCCAM?
Qui s'appelle le CDCAM?
Answer.
Réponse.
Yes, I gave
oui.
an interview to
J'ai
that,
accordé
that investigator.
Un entretien à ces enquêteurs.
That organized the representative of that organization went to my house and
de cette organisation. Ils sont venus
me.
Chez
I
moi,
do not recall
ils m'ont interrogé,
was.
Mais je ne sais pas exactement quand cela s'est passé.
Maybe I can assist you, Mr.
Question.
Witness. Would, that, would it be possible
aider,
that it was around
en
April 2011?
C'était peut-être en avril 2011.
Thank you.
L'accusation.
Good morning, Your Honor's Counsel.
Merci, Monsieur
and everyone
Président.
Present. My understanding from the ruling that Your Honors gave last
Après
night
le,
is that the interview
hier,
the counsel is now asking about and providing a date to the witness for is one that we are not allowed to ask questions about. Your Honors, in paragraph 4, I believe, of your decision indicated that this was excluded. So does that apply to all parties? I'm just bringing that to Your Honor's attention.
Mr. President, if I may respond,
Copé,
of course I'm well aware of your decision
réponds,
of last night.
Plaît,
I wasn't going to ask him anything on the content
hier,
of his statement, merely confirmation that in fact he spoke to DCCAM. I believe it's also mentioned
CDCAM,
in his WRI,
je crois que c'est
dans but I'll be happy to move on quickly.
We would, however, ask the parties not to ask leading questions as per our instructions. So if you could... We understand that these are facts already put before the chamber, the prior interviews, but if just for the future reference, if you could just ask when it was and where it was, as opposed to putting the answer already, it would be more compliant with our directions. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Judge Millar.
I
will try to avoid
Je vais
leading questions also in
de poser des questions
non-contentious areas. Mr. Witness, did you speak to the investigators of the investigating judges more recently?
Avez-vous répondu aux questions des enquêteurs des juges d'instruction plus récemment?
Answer yes.
Réponse oui.
I have been interviewed the last few
entendu
months.
Au cours des derniers mois.
And where were you interviewed?
Question. Et où avez-vous été interrogé?
Which location was
à quel endroit?
Some answer.
Réponse.
I would like to tell the court that I
je
gave an interview once at Jingdong Commune office,
and
I was once again interviewed last month
et que j'ai également
at
été
the office, the commune
le
office.
Mois dernier, au sein du bureau de la commune.
President, Mr. Witness, could you clarify for the chamber?
Pourriez-vous préciser, je vous prie?
Where were you interviewed?
Où avez-vous été interrogé?
Once again, last month.
Le mois dernier. Pour la deuxième fois.
President, please wait for
le
the
président,
microphone to go on before you speak.
Veuillez attendre que votre micro soit allumé, s'il vous plaît. Le témoin.
Witness. I was interviewed last month.
J'ai été interrogé le mois dernier.
At the trial chamber, said the witness. I do not recall when it
instance,
was.
Instance, dit le témoin, mais je ne sais pas quand exactement.
Do you know whether it was a month ago or 2 months
question,
ago?
Savez-vous si cela s'est passé il y a un mois, deux
can
mois
you
ou trois
a
mois?
Little more specific?
Pourriez-vous être un peu plus précis, s'il vous plaît?
Some can be answer.
Réponse.
I do not recall it.
Je ne m'en souviens pas.
And as I stated, I gave the interview already
dit,
to investigator, and I believe
je
that there is a written
avec
statement.
Les
perhaps
qu'il y a un procès-verbal
this before you.
Vous avez probablement
Mr. Witness, do you remember whether they told you
question,
why they wanted to interview you again?
S'ils vous ont dit pourquoi ils étaient vous interroger à nouveau?
Answer no.
Réponse non.
For the record, Mr. President,
question.
It seems that we
mémoire, Monsieur le Président,
are not in the possession of any second.
Nous n'avons pas été saisis d'un
written record of interview.
Deuxième
but I will move on with my questions.
Mr.
Witness, can you tell us whether you
Monsieur
have
témoin,
siblings?
Pourriez-vous nous dire si vous avez des frères et sœurs?
Answer. I have brother
réponse.
And sisters.
Oui, j'ai des frères et sœurs.
Some are your brother, ma. That's all.
Can you tell us
question.
How many brothers
pourriez-vous
you
nous
have
dire combien de frères vous
at
avez
this moment?
À l'heure actuelle?
Answer.
Réponse.
I have 8 siblings.
J'ai 8 frères
3
et sœurs.
Brothers, 5
3 frères
sisters.
Et 5 sœurs.
Please be informed.
Would you be so kind, Mr. Witness, and tell us the
Monsieur
names
témoin,
of your two brothers?
Plaît, nous donner
of
le
your
nom
brothers?
De vos frères.
Answer. I can
réponse.
Tell you.
Oui.
My elder brother's
mon frère aîné.
Name is Sao Jurun.
S'appelle Sao Jurun.
And my younger brother's
Mon
name is
cadet.
Sao Chamraun.
S'appelle Sao Chamraun.
Currently, Sao Chamraun is living
Sao
in Phnom Penh.
Vit.
And as for my elder brother, Sao Jurun,
quant à Sao Jurun, mon frère aîné,
he is residing at Roca Commune,
il vit dans la
Trang
commune de
District,
Roca,
Takao Province.
La province de Takeo.
What are the present occupations or functions of your brother,
question.
Of your brothers?
Quelle est la profession de vos frères à l'heure actuelle?
Bah. Answer.
Réponse.
My elder brother is living with
mon frère aîné
his children.
Vit avec ses
he has
enfants.
No occupation.
Il n'a pas de profession.
And as for, it is the same case for my younger brother.
Même chose pour mon frère cadet.
And what is your present function, if
question.
Any?
Question. Et quelle fonction occupez-vous à l'heure actuelle, le cas échéant? Réponse.
Answer. Currently, I am a farmer, rice farmer, and
je
as I stated, I am a member of
comme je l'ai dit, je suis également
membre
Council du conseil de la commune de Jiangdong dans la province de Takeo.
Of which political party are you a commune councillor?
Question. Pourriez-vous nous dire depuis quand vous êtes membre du conseil de la commune?
Answer.
Réponse.
I am a member of
je suis
party.
Membre
le parti bon.
Du parti de
Samyangsi. And now, the Samyangsi party and Human Rights Party combined
parti
together and it become known as National
Recusa
Party. How about a younger sister of yours, Sao Van.
Question. L'une de vos jeunes sœurs, Sao Van.
What can you tell us about her?
Elle s'appelle Sao Van. Que pourriez-vous nous dire à son sujet?
Answer. My
réponse.
Younger sister, Sao Van,
ma sœur cadette,
is
Sao
living
Van.
At Phnom Penh. Commune,
vit dans la commune de
Phnom Penh, Battambang
province. Dans le même
province.
District, province de
Battambang. She is an owner of a vegetable farm.
Elle possède une entreprise de.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. I will return to all three of them a bit later. I would now like to ask you a few questions in relation to the period 1917-1975. Would you please describe?
Question.
Your functions or
Monsieur le témoin,
positions
j'aimerais à présent que vous nous parliez des fonctions que vous avez occupées dans la période de, qui s'est écoulée entre 75 et 77.
Answer.
Réponse.
Concerning my background and activities from 1970
tout ce qui est de mon passé,
and 1975,
et de ce que j'ai vécu entre 1970 et 1975,
the coup d'état
et après
1970,
le coup d'état
I was an ordinary rice farmer.
Je dois dire que j'étais un riziculteur ordinaire.
In 30th September,
le
1971,
Anka
assigned me
Lankar
to a position as the chief of Jiangdong
chef du village
commune
de Jiangdong,
front.
Du front de la commune
and
de
I was in that position during that time until 1975,
jusqu'à 1975,
when the war was over. And later on, Anka
par la suite,
sent me to
Lankar
live in
m'a envoyé vivre
sector 25.
Dans le secteur 25.
Would you describe
question.
The functions of your role as chief of the front of Chang Trong commune?
Le rôle que devait jouer le chef de la commune de Chang Trong.
Answer. I can only tell what I have remembered.
Je peux vous parler uniquement de ce dont je me souviens.
Chief of the Chang Trong front.
En tant que chef du front de Chang Trong,
the front was collecting all the patriots. All the people who were loyal to the party,
sachant que le front to join forces
and fight against the Lonol forces.
Lutter contre les forces de Lonol.
From my recollection and my understanding, Anka told us that we had to join together to fight against the imperialist America, which have a Lunar regime to depose the late King Sihanouk.
Contre le régime de Lonol qui avait renversé.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Did you have other functions
question,
or positions
Merci, Monsieur Témoin. Occupiez-vous d'autres
in the period
fonctions
1970-1975?
Dans la période de
1970-1975. Answer. I had no other position other than being chief of a Chang Trong
front. Que le poste de chef du front de Chang Trong.
Were you
question.
Involved in the movement in another commune
avez-vous pu part in au Trump mouvement dans district, une autre commune
Popel,
du district de Trump
you have a function in Popel commune?
Dans la commune de Popel plus précisément.
Answer. On the 1st of January 1971,
Anka
assigned me
Lankar
to be a member in the community committee to gather the people.
Chargé.
I work with my
de
comrade
rassembler Kuhn. Les gens. Et j'ai travaillé avec le camarade Kuhn.
And as I stated, I was removed
comme je
from
Popel. J'ai été retiré de Popel
on the 30th of September 1971, and I was put in a position as the chief of Popel.
C'est à ce moment-là que je suis devenu chef.
When you were moved from your position in Popel, did you ever return
question.
To Popel,
êtes-vous revenu à Popel
to fulfill any function?
Pour occuper certaines fonctions?
Answer.
Réponse.
When I came to live and work in
lorsque
the
je
Popel,
suis allé vivre
I was not
et travailler à Popel,
chief
je n'étais
of
pas
Popel.
Chef.
I was part
commune.
Of a re-education committee of
Popel
commune,
and
Kuhn was the one who had overall supervision of that commune.
Supervisait cette commune.
Mr. Witness, in my
question.
English translation, I
Monsieur
hear the word re-education committee.
J'ai entendu parler comité de rééducation en anglais, dans l'interprétation anglaise.
Giving it back to you in English, would it be a better way to formulate it in terms of a mobilizing committee or an education committee?
Le titre de ce comité.
Maybe my question wasn't very clear. I'll move
ma
on.
Ma question n'est peut-être pas suffisamment claire. Je vais poursuivre,
would
Monsieur le Témoin.
Would you be so kind and tell us
auriez-vous
whether
l'amabilité de
your
dire
two brothers,
si vos deux
Sao Sum and Sao Shroom and your sister Salvan at any functions or positions between 1970 and
1975?
Some answer. Regarding my younger sister, Salvan,
pour ce qui est de ma sœur cadette, Salvan,
she then joined in the education committee of Popel.
Elle a travaillé pour le comité d'éducation dans la commune de Popel. Et après la fin de la guerre, en 1975,
Lanka
l'a envoyé à Sri Ambol,
from my recollection.
D'après mes souvenirs.
Brother Sao Chamran.
Quant à Sao Chamran,
he had no function at that time. He was merely a rice farmer
at
a Kwai village,
dans le village de Kwai,
Takao province,
province of Takao,
from 1970 to 1975.
What about your older brother, Sao Sum?
Question,
what was
de votre
his,
aîné,
if
Sao
any,
Sum?
Function? Between 1970 and 75.
Occupait-il des fonctions particulières entre 1970 et 1975?
But some club.
Answer.
Réponse.
Regarding my elder brother, Sao Chun.
Pour ce qui est de Sao Chun, mon frère aîné.
From 1970 and 1975, his name was
Sao Chun.
He was
a
deputy commune chief
il était chef
in the quarter 3 in Phnom Penh. He was working for Lon Nol region.
Il travaillait pour le régime de Lon Nol.
What exactly did he do within the Lon Nol administration? What were his tasks?
Quelle tâche accomplissait-il?
Somme Kimrib Kalkanong Rabob.
Réponse.
Answer. In Lon Nol regime, as I stated,
comme je l'ai dit,
he was the third deputy chief in the quarter number 6 in Phnom Penh.
De Phnom Penh sous le régime de Lon Nol.
And are you able to remember what tasks he had in this job of third assistant in the 6th commune? What did he do? Do you remember?
Savez-vous ce qu'il faisait? Vous en souvenez-vous?
Answer. I have no idea.
Réponse, je n'en ai pas la moindre idée.
I will get back to your brothers a little later, Mr. Witness. I will move
tard,
on now
témoin,
to my next question.
Chose,
and that is relating to the period as of 17 April 1975, the day of the liberation.
Jour de la libération.
Can you please tell us what your function was
on the 17
April of 75 and thereafter?
Le 17 avril 1975 et par la suite.
Answer.
Réponse.
Your question is, after 17 April 1975 and afterwards,
vous me demandez,
you wanted to know about my position. I was
quelles étaient mes fonctions à partir du 17 avril
1975?
J'étais secrétaire
in
à Kandahar
province.
It,
that
province de
area was referred to as Sector 25.
C'était la région que l'on appelait le secteur 25.
You're describing,
question.
Mr. Witness, another position
Monsieur
in another témoin, sector.
Vous parlez d'autres fonctions
do you recall
dans un autre secteur?
When you became
vous souvenez-vous du moment
the commune chief
où vous êtes
of Kampong Svei,
chef
commune in
commune de
Kings Svei, district?
Dans le district de Kings Svei.
Informe.
Réponse.
Answer. I would like to confirm the question You want to know about my position in the period? I do not really get your question.
I will clarify, Mr. Witness. You told us that you were the chief of the front of Chang Trong commune, and that after 17 April 1975, you then became the chief of commune in Kampong Sve commune, which is in sector 25. Now my question is, when did you get the latter position? Which year, which month, do you recall?
Answer.
Réponse.
I cannot recall it.
Je ne m'en souviens pas.
3 months after the 17th of April 1975.
3 mois après le 17 avril 1975.
Sector 25 was considered to be in the southwest zone. And at that time, I was sent to Kien Swai district by
Angkar. District de Kien Swai par Angkar.
It was in 1976 that I held that position. As I stated, I do not recall the exact date.
Mais je ne me souviens plus de la date précise.
I understand, Mr. Witness, no problem. Do you remember when you were still a chief of Chang Trong commune, in which district and sector and zone that commune was?
Vous souvenez-vous donc du district ou du secteur à laquelle appartenait ce village?
Answer. Jing Tong commune was located in Tramka.
Était dans le district de Tramka.
And it was in district 105.
C'était le district
sector
105.
13. It is currently 13. Known as Takao province.
At that time,
this commune was in the southwest zone.
À l'époque, c'était dans la zone sud-ouest.
Before you moved to another sector, sector 25,
you were in district 105.
Do you recall any members of the committee of district 105? Do you recall anybody who were assigned to work in district 105 in Tramkak district?
Qui avait été envoyé au district de Tramkak?
In district 105,
réponse.
I only recall
au district 105,
Ye Kong,
je ne me souviens que de Ye Kong
and Danieu.
Et Danieu.
Besides these three, there were others.
Il y en avait d'autres.
However, I was not sure of their positions.
Mais je ne suis pas
I also recall another name, that is Pichim.
Il y a Pichim aussi dont je me souviens.
What do you recall about these people, Kom and Boon and Pekchim? Can you tell us?
Kom, Boon et les autres.
Kom was Tamok's daughter,
Kom
who was chief
fille de
of Tramkok district, that is
chef
district 105.
Du district 105.
And Niu was a member. Qui was also a member of district 105.
Qui était aussi membre du district 105.
And what about Pekchim? What do you recall of him?
De Pekchim.
At that point in time, Pichim was a teacher.
Pichim était enseignant.
However, he was considered a petty bourgeoisie. and for that reason he was not given any particular role. He tried to adapt himself to the revolutionary movement in order to avoid being risk of being alert to have involvement with the former Lunol and the imperialist regime.
When you were recently interviewed here at the court,
vous avez été entendu tout
were you asked questions about Baek Chim?
Vous a-t-on posé des questions au sujet de Baek Chim?
But
yes, I was. Réponse. They asked me questions about Baek Chim.
Oui, on m'a posé des questions au sujet de Baek Chim.
That he was tasked to deal with economic issues and logistics within the communes under the city, under the district. For mass meetings, for example, he would gather rice, food from those communes to supply the battlefield. And that was the limit of his role, and I'm certain of his role from my recollection and from what I observed at the time.
C'est ce dont je me souviens.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Let me move on to
Merci,
the
Clément.
Level above
je vais parler
the District 105.
Supérieur
that would be
Sector
13.
105,
le do you recall 13. Any leading members of Sector 13?
Vous souvenez-vous
1975, 1976.
Personne du secteur 13 pendant la période.
I didn't know who
réponse.
Was in the position at the sector
je
level
ne savais pas qui
between 76 to 75 to 76 since I had
left
76, already.
Car j'avais déjà quitté.
Mr. President, with your leave, maybe I can refresh
Monsieur le Président, avec votre the witness's
memory. Does the name Son Meyers-Mout ring a bell?
Meyers-Mout, est-ce que cela vous rafraîchit la mémoire?
I can recall that Saum
je me souviens
and
que Saum
Mihmut
et Meyers-Mout
who were called at the time as Tasaum, Tamut, and another one, Tapain. The trio was in charge of Sector 13 at the time.
Do you recall anything specific about Tasaum?
Vous souvenez-vous de quelque chose en particulier à propos de l'une quelconque de ces trois personnes?
Allow me to clarify your question.
Réponse. Laissez-moi
from
peut-être
my
préciser votre
recollection,
question. D'après mes souvenirs,
and through the training that I received,
et d'après la formation que j'avais reçue, ces trois personnes, donc Mut et Pain,
they conducted a yearly study session which I attended.
Organisait une session d'études annuelle à laquelle j'ai participé.
Of a solidarity
et il a parlé
within
de
the
solidifier
party.
Notre position de solidarité au sein du parti.
Solidarity within and throughout the chain of command, with the ultimate purpose
de la chaîne
to
de dont l'objectif final
the people
était de
faithfully.
Servir le peuple. Fidèlement.
They also reiterated the point of the circulation of directions from the upper echelon down to the base.
La diffusion des instructions depuis les échelons supérieurs jusqu'à la base.
Who was instructed to implement those
donc,
instructions had to implement them regardless of their knowledge or the limitation of the understanding
œuvre,
of those circulars. And you
circulaires.
Had to seek clarification later,
et
but
qu'il fallait
first,
poser des questions plus tard.
It has to be implemented,
dit, il fallait mettre and you had les instructions to en œuvre.
Abide by the majority, to respect the majority and not the minority, and you had to respect the chain of command.
Et respecter
that is,
la
the
chaîne
lower
de command.
Level had to respect the upper echelon.
Les instructions venant de l'échelon.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Now moving question. Up
merci,
to the zone at the time. Do you remember who the leader was of the Southwest Zone?
Qui dirigeait la zone sud-ouest?
75, 76.
Entre 75 et 76.
Som Kim Riep, no som nang thai no som nua, khnyom man ban.
I didn't have any detailed knowledge about the zone structure. I only knew that Tamok was at the zone level for the southwest zone. And besides Tamok, I didn't know anyone else who was at the zone level. And I always adhered to my principle that I minded my own business and I never wanted to poke my finger into other people's affairs, and as I just told you, I only knew Tamok was
comme
at the zone
dit,
level.
Plutôt, c'est Tamok qui était au niveau de la zone.
Does the name
question.
Chuchet,
est-ce que le nom de Chuchet ring a bell? Vous rappelle quelque chose?
I recall that name, but your question is specific, that is for the period between 75 to 76, and between that period I didn't know anything about Chuchet. Prior to that, that is around 1970 or 71, I knew about Chuchet as he was with Tamok, and I attended a conference where he was there and monks were there. And I was tasked to gather people to make offerings to the monks during that meeting. And that's how I came to know Chuchet. I only knew him, rather I only saw him, but I didn't have any personal contact with him at the time.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Before I would like to ask you some more questions about Tamok and Tasson.
Je vais vous poser d'autres questions sur Tamok et Tasson.
Like to ask you about
your brothers. J'aimerais vous poser des questions au sujet de
vos frères. What happened to your two brothers on the day of the liberation and thereafter? Do you recall?
Qu'est-il advenu de vos deux frères le jour de la libération et par la suite? Vous en souvenez-vous?
For my younger brother, Sao Jim Rown, I was unaware of any issues that he had, as he was simply a peasant between 1970 to 1975. However, Sao Sum, Elias Trum, who was my elder brother, left Phnom Penh,
a quitté Phnom Penh,
and he told my parents that when he left, he was heading north through Kampong Thom province.
Il a dit qu'il allait vers le nord, vers Kampong Thom.
3 months after, while he was en route,
trois mois plus tard,
he arrived at our house.
Il est arrivé chez nous.
And due to his previous position, he was called to attend an education
et compte tenu de le poste qu'il avait occupé précédemment, on l'a convoqué à une séance
area,
au bureau 24.
And that's the limit of my knowledge of his whereabouts and activity at the time.
À ce propos.
Do you know whether he was arrested and subsequently
question.
Detained in office 204?
Savez-vous s'il a été arrêté et emprisonné au bureau 24?
Yes, I was aware of that at the time.
Oui, je l'ai su.
Do you know
à l'époque.
How long he
question.
Was detained? in office 204?
Pendant combien de temps il a été détenu au bureau 24?
204 sur 24. Là, il me dit, mais non.
Réponse.
At that time, he, with his family, went to office 204, says the witness.
À l'époque, donc, lui et sa famille sont allés au bureau 204. And
by that time, I had left to Sector 25 and I lost contact with him and his family.
J'ai perdu contact.
I might get back to him, but because of time, I'm now moving, Mr. Witness, to Tamok. Do you recall ever having attended meetings of cadres, military people, of district people, to which Tamok and others attended? Have you ever been present at a meeting presided by Tamok?
Participé à une réunion présidée par Tamok?
Yes, I did.
Réponse. Oui.
I attended a yearly conference.
Oui, j'ai participé at à une sector 13, réunion annuelle au secteur 13.
And Tamok participated in the meeting.
Tamok était présent.
And he was present there for an hour. The main content of his speech was to remind the cadres, the soldiers, and the peasants that we all had to hold our strong and firm solidarity and to reduce more rice yields
et d'augmenter les récoltes.
On the issue of life of people and in our position, in our leading positions at the commune or the district or the provincial level, we did not have the authority to decide the life and death of the people.
Pas le droit de
and
décider de vie ou de mort.
Anyone who violated this principle
toute
means
qui
that, that individual had to dig a grave for himself.
Devait creuser sa propre tombe.
In his speech, he reiterated that within the zone,
that
the life issue
que dans la zone,
was at the ultimate hand of the zone
c'était
and
la zone
the center.
Qui décidait de vie ou de mort, et le centre.
Question.
Inaudible pour l'interprète.
And allow me to add a little bit more.
Réponse. Je vais ajouter quelque chose.
And in late 1976, during a meeting where all cadres within the entire southwest zone were called to attend in Takao province, I apologize. In fact, it was held in 1973.
Cette réunion a eu lieu en 1973.
During the meeting,
donc, lors de cette
réunion,
that Tamok,
we had to carry two tasks simultaneously.
Nous devions accomplir deux tâches.
And he stressed that the Vietnamese and the imperialists
il a dit que les Vietnamiens et les impérialistes
negotiation to a ceasefire in
Prenokor après Prenokor
in order to grant time to the imperialists to gather their war weaponry, including
renforcer le
airplanes and fighter jets,
y compris
in order to be redeployed to bombard Cambodia.
Et les bombardiers pour bombarder le Cambodge.
Took hostage of Cambodia
et
to compel us to join them to fight against the imperialists.
Pour nous forcer à lutter contre les impérialistes.
However, Tamok stressed at the time
et c'est ce que Tamok nous a rappelé à l'époque,
had to know
nous devions
the imperialists and the communists both are aiming to attack
et les communistes voulaient nous attaquer.
And that we had to strive hard to convince the people not to sell rice to the Vietnamese,
convaincre le peuple de ne pas
not to sell any poultry to the Vietnamese, and if they were to ask to buy
the poultry or rice,
those peasants would tell them that now Vietnam enjoys peace, so there was no need for them to seek or purchase
a rice or poultry from Cambodia.
He continued to stress that both the communists and the imperialists were about to attack us.
And
as an example, he gave about the situation of the former Soviet Union who placed its embassy within the Lunar regime. That's the main gist of his meeting at the time.
Thank you, do you recall whether Tamok at that meeting or other meetings before the liberation also spoke about soldiers of the Lon Nol Republic? Did he ever express an opinion as to the position of these soldiers or how he viewed them? Do you recall anything that he ever said about soldiers in the Lon Nol army?
Souvenez-vous si Tamok a évoqué les soldats qui intégraient l'armée de Lon Nol?
Some try got, but out there in jail, got, but the car got caught up from more complaining
regarding that.
No,
the content that he focused on was to mobilize forces in order to attack and liberate Phnom Penh.
Il était surtout concentré à mobiliser les forces pour attaquer Phnom Penh.
Had known by then about the competing force between our force and the Lon Nol side, and our ultimate aim was to attack and liberate Phnom Penh from the regime.
Did he ever say what should happen to ranking officers of the former Lon Nol army before the liberation?
Ce que l'on devait faire des officiers de l'armée de Lon Nol avant la libération.
Sorry, Mr. President.
Le procureur.
I apologize. Just to get your, may I please express that we believe this is a leading question. The witness can
nous
be asked what Tam Mok said. He was asked specifically what he said about Lon Nol soldiers.
Ce qui est Tam Mok a dit,
putting specific words
à propos
to the witness suggests an answer, in our view.
De suggérer la réponse au témoin est inacceptable.
I'm not sure if
the answer was quite unambiguous that the witness remembers that Tam Mok said nothing else.
Il a dit que Tam Mok n'avait rien dit d'autre.
Mr. President, I'm not sure if I followed the objection, but I will try to rephrase.
Monsieur le Président, je pense que vous avez bien compris cette objection, mais je
Tam Mok ever said anything.
Monsieur le témoin.
Before the liberation of 1975, about what should happen to soldiers of the Lon Nol army with a rank.
Des soldats, des officiers de l'armée de Lon Nol.
Before the liberation, he didn't say anything
avant
to
la libération,
that effect.
Il n'a rien dit de la sorte.
However, 3 months after the liberation,
3 mois après la libération,
Ta invited concerned cadres within Sector 13.
A invité les cadres concernés du secteur 13.
And he advised or informed.
Dans le cadre
the cadre
de cette réunion, les cadres,
the former soldiers up to the rank
que les anciens soldats
of colonel should not be harmed
ne devaient pas
because those soldiers
attaqués.
As an entity
car
at least had their family members who lived in the liberated zone and who contributed to the liberation
donc,
of the country and who actually joined with us in the liberation. So for that reason, they should not be harmed.
Il ne fallait pas.
Let me go to that meeting, Mr. Witness. Do you recall where this meeting was.
J'aimerais parler de cette réunion. Vous souvenez-vous où cette réunion a eu lieu, où Tassam et Tamok ont dit cela?
First, I will Tassam. Do you recall where this meeting was when Tassam spoke about this?
Maître Coppe. Oui, Tassam seulement. Vous souvenez-vous où est cette réunion où Tassam a parlé de cela?
At that time, Tamok was absent.
À l'époque, Tamok n'était pas là.
And Sam invited cadres to attend a meeting at Klein Mountain and District 106, which is Songkhorje District currently.
Le district de Songkhorje actuel.
What else do you recall about this
question.
Meeting? Can you recall who else was present?
Et
how many people were present? What do you recall?
Y avait-il? Vous souvenez-vous combien de participants il y avait? Vous souvenez-vous d'autres détails?
I cannot recall everyone who attended the meeting.
Je ne me souviens pas de tous ceux qui ont participé.
However, participants included
parmi soldiers, les participants, il y avait des soldats,
commune cadres,
des cadres
and office committees,
de la commune,
though I cannot recall their names.
Bureau.
And they came from various districts within the sector.
Districts, au sein du secteur.
Now, do you recall when you were at that meeting what the political line was
alors que vous étiez
in terms of
what
to do with officers
or
soldiers
pour les soldats
from the Lonel Army? What was, in your recollection, the political line in your district,
d'après vos souvenirs, quelle était la ligne politique au sein de votre district
with Lonel officers or soldiers?
Réservé aux soldats de Lonel et aux officiers.
On l'issue of the lines,
sur la question,
I actually mentioned something to that effect in theory about the lines.
Le principe a été évoqué.
And if you want to refer to the lines that were taught to us, that is the minority had to respect the
la
majority, the lower
la minorité
echelon
devait
had to respect the upper echelon.
L'échelon inférieur devait respecter les instructions émanant des échelons supérieurs.
And therefore, the party's structure, three member sub-branches form a party's branch.
Structure du parti, trois membres.
And for the implementation of the circulars or instructions from the upper echelon,
la mise en œuvre
those instructions had to be implemented first, even if you did not fully understand it, and you might seek clarification later, that is, after its implementation.
Après la mise en œuvre.
Thank you, Mr. Witness, but I'm asking you specifically
oui, merci,
as to, if you recall,
si vous vous souvenez,
the political line,
la ligne politique,
around the liberation in 75 and thereafter in respect of the fate of Lonel soldiers or officers. What do you remember was the fate supposed to be of these military? Were they to be killed or were they to be spared? Do you recall?
Vous souvenez-vous de ce qui a été dit?
I remember clearly that from the foot soldier up to the rank of colonel, those military personnel or soldiers
rang de colonel
should not be harmed.
Devait être
épargné. That is my recollection.
Voilà ce dont je me souviens. Question.
What do you mean with should not be harmed?
Que voulez-vous dire par épargné ou qu'il ne fallait pas les toucher?
som thlai khnyom sabai chet
pro tha khmae nang khmae ban
chuk chei hai ba
chna hai chuk I was very happy to hear that as we gained a victory for all the Cambodian people.
J'étais bien heureux d'apprendre cela car nous avions en effet obtenu la victoire pour tout le peuple cambodgien.
I was happy and jubilant for all the former officials and that soldiers from the foot soldier through the rank of colonel soon behind.
Qu'il était interdit de toucher aux soldats jusqu'à ceux occupant le rang de colonel.
I did not have any clear stance on the issue of the former officials or the military personnel, but I was jubilant to hear the new or instructions.
Fonctionnaire, mais j'étais très heureux d'apprendre cette nouvelle.
So is my understanding correct that around the time of the liberation, 17 April 1975,
la date de la libération, 17 avril,
the policy was, the political line was, not to harm military up until the rank of colonel, meaning that they should not be killed or executed. Is that correct?
Mr. Deputy Co-Prosecutor, Mr. President,
Monsieur le Président,
the line of questioning on the issue of party lines put by the Co-Defense Council to the witness was in relation to a meeting which was convened at a Trianon Mountain. However, it seems that the council tries to summarize about the party lines throughout the regime and not the party lines mentioned during that meeting. So please, clarification. President, Council, your question is leading, so please refresh it.
Adopté lors de cette réunion. Le Président, vous posez une question orientée, Maître, donc veuillez, je vous prie, reformuler.
I'm not sure if I understand your decision.
Je ne comprends pas bien votre décision, Monsieur le Président.
Mr. Witness, let me try rephrase.
Monsieur le
you spoke about meetings before 75,
vous avez parlé de réunions
the liberation and after.
Avant la libération de 1960.
Was it your understanding at the time
après
that former Lon Nol soldiers and officers up until the rank of colonel were not to be harmed, were not to be killed, were not to be executed. Is that correct?
It's the same objection. The witness could be asked what was the line, in fact he was, and he gave his answer. Now, counsel is restating.
Indeed, we feel répète. That you're summarizing and objecting to the summary takes as much time probably as the summary itself.
Vous savez,
we, I think, are capable of making inferences résumé, of the questions and answers so far. So if we could move on.
Peut-on passer à autre chose?
We understand that the witness answered about pre-liberation and after liberation, but we understood that it was still around 1975. If this understanding would be incorrect, please pursue further. If not, we can move on.
Thank you, Judge Millard. I will move on. Mr. Witness, you spoke about a meeting where these issues were discussed
at Promontory Mountain,
if I recollect correctly. Do you also know about a meeting in which similar issues were discussed, which was held somewhere else, more specifically in Takeo provincial town?
Dans le chef-lieu de province de Takeo, plus précisément.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. La question est me semble leading. Pour reprendre un anglicisme, la réponse est dans la question. Le confrère pourrait-il reformuler de manière plus neutre?
I believe that the colleague should put this question again in a more neutral fashion. Thank you.
Mr. President, of course I would do so, but I'm looking
bien entendu,
at the clock and
I
have, I think, 5 more minutes.
Je
so,
qu'il me reste seulement 5 minutes.
But let me rephrase.
Je vais
Mr. Witness, do you recall
Monsieur
any
témoin,
meeting
vous
where similar issues were discussed anywhere else than at Promontory Mountain?
ailleurs que vers cette montagne.
Witness, I do not
réponse.
Really get your question.
J'ai
what
pas très bien
do you want
votre
me
question.
To clarify?
Que souhaitez-vous que je précise?
You spoke about a meeting.
Question. Vous avez parlé d'une réunion
where the fate of
au cours de laquelle on a discuté du sort réservé aux anciens soldats de l'ONU.
Do you recall also other meetings where similar or the similar issue was discussed?
Desquelles?
Anywhere else in,
on aurait abordé les
in
mêmes
your
questions
district or in your zone.
Dans votre district ou dans votre zone.
Witness, let me clarify.
Réponse, je vais préciser.
I am now referring to cadre at commune and
je parle
district
des cadres
levels
au niveau
after they receive
des communes et des districts.
And after
ces cadres
the meeting, they had to relay the instructions
et après
to
les réunions,
their
ils
colleagues
relayer
at the commune and district
level.
And
et
they
des districts.
Had to discipline and educate their
ils devaient
members at the
éduquer
commune
leurs
and
membres,
district
les discipliner
levels.
Au niveau des communes et des districts.
And they had to instruct them that not to intimidate people at the commune and district level.
Les gens au niveau des communes et des districts.
And everyone has to mobilize food supplies. These were the activities that we
vivres.
Did at that time.
Voilà ce que nous
and as I stated, instruction would
comme
be relayed to, the, to members of the commune and district levels.
Maybe my question wasn't clear,
question
Mr. Witness. My question was, do you recall other meetings
si vous
anywhere
vous
in 1975
qui lieu en 1975
during which it was discussed that soldiers up until the rank of colonel should not be harmed or killed? Any other meetings other than the one you just described?
Pensez-vous à d'autres réunions au cours desquelles on aurait abordé cette question?
But
answer no.
Réponse non.
Mr. President, I have now, I think,
Maître
reached a moment that I should be able to confront the witness with a meeting described
avec une réunion qui a été décrite
by another witness,
par un autre témoin,
Pek Chim. Meeting in Takio provincial
une
town.
Réunion qui a eu lieu
so, with your leave, I would
like
to confront
si
the witness about with a meeting that Pek Chim described. Mr. Witness, do you recall a meeting in
Monsieur
Takio provincial town
in
a building
Takeo,
behind the party office, north part of town, Takio town, along
ville,
the river,
le long
where
de la
such same orders were issued?
Au cours de laquelle les mêmes ordres auraient été donnés.
Had left Tramcock district sector 13 and came to live in sector
25.
I attended a meeting at Sa Cha. There were no inhabitants at that time, and I was there.
Il n'y avait pas d'habitants à l'époque.
I knew that there was a livelihood meeting at that time to strengthen the stance to make a good harvest.
Pour parler
Let
de
me
la façon dont
remind
on
you
les
of your own earlier statement.
Question. J'aimerais
Mr.
passer
Witness, and I'm referring, Mr. President, to document E127/7.8.7.1.8 More specifically, English ERN 0090951570, English, Khmer 008-93277, and French 00978649. That's question A9 and answer. Let me read that to you, Mr. Witness, and that may recall. That may jog your memory.
You said the following.
The question is, when did Grandfather Mock make this?
President, Council, please pause for 1 minute to allow the technician to change the DVD.
Les techniciens doivent changer le DVD.